All right, guys, I'm down here at the Honey Hole in Point. I had about an hour to fish before dark. Thought I'd run down here and make a quick trip. Try something a little different. So tonight, I'm gonna be throwing the first lure that I ever threw in my life as a bass fisherman. Threw it when I was 5 years old. It's a MEPS inline spinner. Stay tuned. We're about to get this inline spinner out there, see what we can do at the Honey Hole. First cast, first fish, he ain't a giant, but hey, who's counting, right? That's a little better fish, guys. Cast number two. Cast number two, two fish. A little better fish. He probably weighs about a pound. Well, guys, that's cast number three, and I'm really disappointed I didn't catch a fish on that one. But I did have one strike at it. Out of his mouth. You guys remember this pond has a ton of grass in it. So it's probably going to be a problem, but we'll just pick it out, keep on going, and I'll just rip some of the marabou out of the tail. So won't be as pretty and flashy now, but I bet you'll still catch a fish. Missed one right there, guys. All right, guys, we're going to walk right down the pond. Stay with me, I'll be right back. All right, guys, we've made it over here to the other side of the pond. I've got you guys in the shade. Hopefully this will make a good video. Hopefully y'all can see some action here. So back at it with the inline spinner, old school inline spinner. He hit it right at the bank there. That's about five or six casts and three fish. So guys, that answers my question, will the inline spinner still catch fish? believe that's number four. Number five, guys. Back at it. Guys, the lure that I'm throwing is it's a MELPS. It's a half ounce inline spinner, and it's got a little old hair tail on it. It had a little bit of flash on the back of it till I caught that first fish, and then it went by the wayside. So, but they're still hitting it. A little better fish. Looks like he got his belly full of something. All right, guys, let's move on to another spot. Y'all hang tight. More fishing for Greenfish Nation. Hey guys, while we're walking, I'm gonna tell you guys a little story. First time I ever remember bass fishing, I was 5 years old. I went out with my dad and a friend of his. We went out in a flat bottom boat. I don't know how many holes it had in it, but they spent all day catching fish with these MELPS inline spinners. I spent all day bailing water with a coffee can. But I'm 52 years old. That's 47 years ago. I still remember that first fishing trip. Thanks for taking me, Dad. I love you. All right, guys, we're gonna get out here off this deep point, make a few casts, and probably call it a day. I had one follow it in right then, but the spinner wasn't spinning. There we go, there's one. He liked it. Got it right in the nose hole. Oh, there's another one, guys. Another little cuss. Guys, I know we ain't catching nothing super big, but I hope you guys are enjoying watching this inline spinner video. I know I'm enjoying making it. These guys are so much fun to catch. Guys, I think we're about to get into prime time. All right, guys, we're on our way back to the car. Gonna make a few casts along the way and make sure we didn't miss anything over here. Going a little further. Y'all hang tight. Oh man. Well, guys, once again, I'm broke off out here at the honey hole, fishing with 30 pound braid, and I had a little old leader on there that was about, oh, I guess 3 foot long with some 14 pound Suffolk line. I'm not real sure about this Suffolk line. I seem to get broke off a lot. But I want to thank you guys for joining us here and enjoying this while it lasted. I enjoyed making it. Next time you guys are at the tackle shop, stop by and take a look at those inline spinners. They'll still catch fish. Thank you again for joining us. Invite you guys to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. I appreciate every one of you. So we can meet again. I'm John with Greenfish Nations. I want to wish you tight line.